solstice was ten last night. It's the earliest solstice for 280 years. And I was looking for a druid. If anyone could sort of, I don't think there's any druids in Teesside, or County Durham, or North Yorkshire, just to sort of clarify this. But it's always the 21st of June, isn't it? Like the longest day, that's what they call it anyway. So, sorry for getting it wrong with you there, Lynch. You didn't say it was that, because I just said we won't, yeah. But make music day to day, and we should make music every day. Every day should be making music. And Northeast Opera, also known as NEO, are just one of the many community groups who have been shortlisted for an award, which is wonderful that they get this recognition. Now, I've been speaking to Terry Doyle. Now, Terry is part of the opera group and their wellbeing coach. And tell us about what they do.
We're making music, you know, charging from the margins. Don't be put off by the word opera. It's music for the people. It's all genres of music. From opera, we do a few opera songs, to some punk. You know, we do folk music, we do music from all over the world. We're rough around the edges. You know, the people who make up our group, some have had a history of homelessness, drug addiction, mental health problems. We've got asylum seekers, got people with mental and physical disabilities, learning disabilities. But by God, when we get together, what a noise we make. And we're keeping music alive, you know, keeping the scene going.
I met you, Terry, at the Christmas light switch on, where you sang in Centre Square, and what was about 2,000-3,000 people, and you had them in the palm of your hands. What is it that you get out of singing, and why is it so important?
Life would be so difficult without music, I always think. We found that through COVID, didn't we, and the lockdowns and all the rest of it, you know. Music, radio became the mainstay of a lot of people's lives during lockdown. You know, just hearing that music in the home and stuff kind of normalised what, you know, some of the horrible things that were going on. It gives me a buzz, Gary, it really does. I've always wanted music, always loved music, from a punk day all the way through. And I got involved in politics through punk and rock against racism and stuff. But everybody involved in our group has got a love and a passion for music. And we've just been nominated for an award. If anybody wants to act that nomination, you know, just go on our website, Northeast Opera, NEO, Creative Lives have put us forward for an award for something that we did recently, and we performed at the Town Hall in Borough called Migrate Folk. And it was an incredible event. There was people crying in the audience. Just the emotion. We charted the history of migration to Teesside through its music. A lot of families, like my own, came from Ireland, for instance. So we did some Irish music, we did some Scottish music. And we had the asylum seekers, the modern day asylum seekers, who were dispersed into Teesside. We had songs from all over the world. And God, it was absolutely brilliant. Asylum seekers these days tend to be used as political footballs. You know, we are about integration. Teesside has always been about that melting pot, people coming to the area for work. You know, and when the Irish came, we had the crack. You know, people worked hard and played hard. And we've got a fabulous culture. Proud to be Smoggies. I could talk all day about this, Gary. It is a real passion. So I get an absolute buzz. I get a real high. And singing's good for our health. You know, mental health improves when we sing. We all know what it's like singing, you know, at the Borough Match, for instance. Collectively coming together, there's something about, you know, setting our isolation aside, you know, it builds cohesion.
Because there's more that connects us than divides us, I think we forget that, don't we? You know, you sit down, and I think social media has a lot to do with this. I mentioned social media a lot. You can easily find a division with somebody, you know, I don't like that, I don't like that. But if you sit down and have a cup of tea with someone, you will find more common ground than divide you when you're face to face. Do you get that with a choir when you get sort of 30, 40 people in a room, they will find that thing. Like sand and water, they will settle to find what connects them.
Yeah, you're right, Gary. Underneath, we're all the same. You know, one of the things I teach as well, because I do well-being work and mental health support and stuff, and I love meditation. When we close our eyes, it doesn't matter what colour skin we've got, it doesn't matter how much money we've got in the bank, it doesn't matter what our sexuality.
relationships that she gets from it. We need to promote more of this, don't we? And music's a great way to do it.
Oh, God, you're right, Gary. And, you know, we're performing at the Middlesbrough Town Hall on July the 15th with the community choir. So they do their set, and they're really good, very polished, you know, a bit hoity-toity and all the rest.
She is from Hemlingdon, you know.
Well, there you go, say the what. And then we come on all rough around the edges and stuff, but together it's like yin and yang, you know, the contrast is great. What I like about the community choir as well, that they're genuinely supportive of the Neo gag. We'll sing songs together as well, and we all perform together with my great folk. And it was a great sound, because the community choir, they're about 100 strong. It's fabulous, it really is. People from all backgrounds again, coming together with a common love of music.
How could anybody not be enthused by just listening to you there? It's Pie Day Friday. Terry's on talking about punk rock and singing. What more do we want? The sun is shining. Get involved. How do people get involved, mate?
And the borough's going to win promotion this season.
Hold on. Let's not push it too far, man.
Well, how do people get involved? Yeah, we meet at the town hall from 4 until 6 on a Monday. So people can turn up then. Or if they want to go on the Facebook page, Neo, or on the website and just get a phone number, or just make contact with us. But everybody's welcome. And don't worry if you think that you can't sing or anything like that. Don't let that be a barrier. Everyone in our group has overcome so many barriers. And coming together and seeing them perform on the stage, the pride that they get, the confidence. These are people with difficult backgrounds. It's all about empowerment, Gary. And you were about empowerment. I listened to your interviews. You're a good man. You're doing really good work locally. Do you understand the crap? You know the culture. This is what Neo are all about as well. Local people celebrating who we are. Proud to be Smoggies, all of it.
And it's the acceptance of, you know, you may not be, look, I'm not from Middlesbrough, I was born in Stockton, lived in Trimden, I'm a County Durham lad, you know, but for 30 years I've been plying my trade in Middlesbrough. Now, I've always loved the town, and I've always loved the club, and I've always loved the people, and I've always loved the area, and that's, it's in us, mate. It's in us.
And all of Teesside, it's not just Borough, is it? You know, let's include the, you know, the Mungiangers over the water and all the rest, because they've got passion for their town as well. You know, we're a passionate area, passionate people. It's Teesside. And a lot of this, I think, is down to the fact that outside of Merseyside, there were more Irish settled on Teesside than anywhere else. So I think we've got that kind of element in our makeup, you know, the crack. We've always worked hard.
But I think port towns, aren't they? You know, Liverpool, Teesside, Tyneside, Humberside, wherever there was a port, there was that melding pot, because stuff would be coming in. And I'm going off track here, but it's sort of in a theme. You know, you would never have got those records coming from America in the 50s if it wasn't for people bringing them back to Liverpool. And, you know, the Beatles wouldn't have been listening to the Isley Brothers. They wouldn't have been listening to those rock and roll tunes. And you wouldn't have had the Beatles if it wasn't for that transient movement between America. And, you know, it's all connected. Chris Rea always talks about listening to music by Sister Rosetta Tharpe and by tuning into sort of American radio and going, ah, wow, that's amazing.
You're right. And on that theme, Gary, right in the Scottish Islands, there was folk music, the fiddle, the diddly eye and stuff, that migrated over to Ireland. You know, people used to have desperate lives, desperate poverty and
up man, and you can be part of it. She said, just check them out, go down, go and meet people, join in if you want, but just be part of something bigger, because we are better when we're part of something bigger, and we're not individuals. We know that. BBC Radio 2 is a great example of that. It's coming up in the next 5-10 minutes, the last lot of finalists for the Make a Difference Awards, where we ask you to nominate people that are doing wonderful stuff in your local community, and you get in touch and you tell us, have you heard of them, have you heard of these wonderful people, that wonderful group, wonderful organisation. We're better together, we are better together. And just from that conversation I had with Terry, a little project I fancy setting up,